Dunn, a volunteer with the University of California Master Gardeners in Santa Clara County. We are at History Park San Jose. Master Gardener volunteers maintain a teaching and demonstration garden here at the historic Umbarger House. Today we want to update our existing drip irrigation system with new components at the hose bib. This video will show you how we're going to do it. Laid out here is a brass Y, a timer, a connector, a vacuum breaker, another connector, a filter, and a pressure regulator. Here is the brass Y. You can see that the top of the Y is attached to the hose bib and our washer is in place. This Y will split the water so that you can have a hose attached to one side and have your irrigation system set attached to the other side. Each side has a valve. This is the timer. At the top of the timer where the water comes in, there is a filter. This filter should be checked periodically. Inside the timer is the control panel so that you can program the timer to automatically water your garden. This is the vacuum breaker. It's also called a backflow preventer. Notice the washer in the top side where the water comes in and the bottom where the water comes out. The screw on the side is used to permanently attach this piece to the assembly. This piece is a brass female-to-female brass adapter. Here at the top where the water comes in, you can see our washer in place. This is threaded to 3/4-inch hose. The bottom where the water comes out is threaded to 3/4-inch plastic pipe. This next piece is the water filter. It will filter out fine particulates from the water. Water flows in from the top here, goes down into the cup, round and round through the filter, and out through the bottom. The filter needs to be cleaned periodically. Begin by removing the drain cap and allowing excess water to drain out. The cap comes off, the filter is removed and cleaned, can then be replaced, screwing the cap back on, and replacing the drain cap. This is a 30 PSI pressure regulator. The water comes in through the top and comes out through a separately purchased connector to our 1/2-inch poly tubing. This is the old system. The plastic parts need to be replaced and we need to put in a vacuum breaker and a pressure regulator. First, we are going to install a new Y on the hose bib so that we can still use a hose alongside the irrigation system. We are going to use a brass Y for durability. Check to make sure there is a washer in place. It's good to have a few extra on hand. All of our attachments will be hand tightened only. We recommend using white Teflon tape at each threaded joint that is brass to plastic to ensure a good seal. Start the Teflon tape a couple of threads from the end and wrap clockwise a couple of times. Next comes the timer. Notice that there are two tightening rings on the timer. We start with the top ring where the screen filter is. That will be attaching to the Teflon tape on the hose bib. After that is tightened, then you will tighten the second lower ring in the opposite direction. There are lots of options for timers. Timers can be programmed to automatically water your garden and reprogrammed as the water needs of your plants change. This timer takes a 9-volt battery that should be changed once a year. Read through the timer's instructions and become familiar with programming it before you put all of these irrigation components together at the hose bib. It's much more comfortable to learn how to use it in the comfort of a chair in the shade than on your knees in the sun. A vacuum breaker, also called the backflow preventer, is now installed to ensure that no contaminants flow back to the water supply. There is a small screw on the side of the vacuum breaker. We will not be using this small screw for this installation. This next piece is the adapter, the brass adapter, female on the top and female on the bottom, that will allow us to connect the hose fitting at the top to the plastic pipe fitting on the bottom. Because there is small particulate matter in all water supplies, it's a very good idea to place a filter in line. To make the installation easier, we have disassembled the filter, and we have already attached our Teflon tape. If you will be connecting to an existing system, we think it would be helpful to connect the pressure regulator to your half-inch poly tubing prior to connecting the pressure regulator to the filter. Once that's in place, you can reassemble the filter pieces. We have finished with our assembly. Here, to recap the parts, at the top we have our brass Y connector. We have our timer with an orange quick release. We have the vacuum breaker, which is the backflow preventer. We have an adapter, that the female to female adapter. We have our filter, and we have the pressure regulator, which is connected to the compression fitting that allows us to connect to the half-inch poly tubing. Here in the kitchen garden, we have a simple irrigation setup. A setup like this is ideal for backyard gardeners or perhaps those renting a home who want an above-ground system that can be relocated if necessary. It is relatively quick to install, affordable, and doesn't require any special tools. Local irrigation supply stores have a good selection of quality products, and many are helpful in answering your questions. So that's how you install irrigation control. Thanks for joining us.
Music by Kevin MacLeod.